Whether it's a power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
It's 2017, Rugby League is back. I'm super excited for the season. It's a little bit cold and we're out in the sticks at Lee versus Wigan for Mickey McLaurin's testimonial. But first up, we're meeting a super fan. We want to meet the super fans across the country this year, Jonesy. Have you ever seen a garden like this before?
This is unbelievable. I've seen a few shrines to Rugby League in my time, but none as casual as this one. When I say casual, I mean just your standard garden covered in corner flags from Ilton Park, Lee's old ground. I think it's absolutely fantastic, Simo.
Right now, Jonesy, ring the bell. Let's meet a very, very special man.
Are we ready? Are we ready? See if he's in.
Hey!
I'm Shandy Bass, Lee's super fan.
Shandy Bass, mate, this garden is absolutely immense, Shandy. You've been collecting, how long have you been collecting memorabilia? How did you come to have half of Hilton Park in your garden?
I just picked it all up and collected it all. And it's just restored here now and it lives here.
Mate, it is a real shrine to the club. How much does Lee Centurions as a club mean to you?
It just means a lot to me because it's a rugby league town in Lee and that's all you can do and enjoy and watch rugby.
One of the best things about you is you're very heavily involved with junior rugby as well, aren't you, down at Lee Miners, or is it Lee Miners? What are you going through a presentation there? Instead of going to Lee match today, you're actually going to a kids' presentation?
Yeah. I'm off to the Lee Miners because I like supporting the junior rugby as well as professional rugby, and would have liked to have been at the Lee game today, but it's the Super League's not far around the corner, and when the real stuff starts, then we're all ready for the real stuff.
And what's your thoughts on a bloke who's really, obviously, we'll look around your garden. It's passionately Lee, and one man who's done more for Lee than most is Derek Beaumont. What's your thoughts on Derek? He's been a great man for the club.
What Derek Beaumont needs to do is carry on in Super League from what he's done last year and make sure we can stay in Super League.
I want to ask you there, Shandy, which of all these little pieces of memorabilia is your favourite? Which is the one that really holds dear to you?
My favourite one is Ilton Park, because that was the name of Lee's ground.
There is.
That's the one, Ilton Park. That was Lee's rugby ground. And we're going back to the old grounds there, which are the old grounds like Nosley Road, Warrington, you name it, Eddingley, Leeds. That's the grounds, the old one.
Originals.
Right, I think we've got a very special visitor, or couple, coming now to the house, to the garden, to meet up with you, Shandy, and tell you that you are Lee's number one fan, mate.
Shandy Bass.
Yeah, Shandy Bass. Hey, Mickey, hiyo.
Hey, Martin Redyard, Shandy Bass.
Shandy Bass is like this lad who used to live next door to Mickey. He's a lot older than him, but he used to like work at McDonald's and everything. And when I was working in a pub, he used to come in and ask for blue WKDs and that. And he said, "Do you want a straw?" Shandy go, "Hey, I'm Butch, mate, I don't need a straw." Mickey signs for Warrington, gets squad number 14. Shandy buys a Warrington polo shirt. In black biro, went back 9 and hiyo. Walking around Lee, innit?
Brilliant.
Loves him, absolutely loves him.
Right, the boys have arrived, come down the street, wrong end to where we're pointing camera, and Riddy's nominated Shandy Bass as a superfan, not just a superfan, but a local celebrity as well. So Riddy gives you a bit of an insight into why Shandy Bass deserves superfan.
Yeah, he's a legend, Shandy. I think everybody knows who he is. If you put him and Donald Trump up at side of each other, and people will say, "Who's that with Shandy Bass?" Which is probably the truth. Nah, I've known Shandy quite a few years. He used to come in every Friday in the pub where I work watching rugby, didn't you, lad? And then in McDonald's, he was a good lad at McDonald's, so he just kept his head down, got on with his job. And I think he followed. I think he's more of a Super Mickey fan than a Super Lee fan.
Shandy, you've got a bit of a special shirt there. Show us your shirt. It might bring back some memories.
Look at this for a shirt.
Is that, where's that shirt from, Mickey? Do you remember wearing that? It looks about three sizes too big.
No, it's not actually my shirt, that. But I do remember the shirt. It weren't my debut shirt, by the way. No, I think I was about 15, 16. I think that was Lee first team shirt. And obviously, I said, I lived next door to Shandy since I was near high to about 15, 16. So he was my next door neighbour for a long time. And obviously, you know, you get friendly with your neighbours, and, you know, he started going into his rugby and kind of, you know, he followed myself around when I was playing. He'd come watch you when I was a kid as well. He's jumping the car with my dad and come watching. So he's been a big supporter of me and, you know, a close friend as well. You know, I've known him nearly all my life. So, and it's nice to see that he's still watching me now.
Shandy, are you excited for the start of the season? And are you going to be singing along supporting Mickey?
Oh, I will be, but the main thing is we've got for Avley, but staying Super League with the lads like Mickey Iron and the lads like Martin Ridyard and with the local talent. And we've got for keep fighting, but be up there.
Top man, it's
with
been
a big boy.
Outstanding to come down and actually stand in the famous Facebook beer garden. I've seen many a video. It's time to go to the game. Mickey McLaurin's testimonial today.
It certainly is, and just gives a bit of an insight into your own opinion of Mickey McLaurin as an unbelievable player. You know his position more than anybody. What's your thoughts on his career so far?
Yeah, I think it's a credit to him. You know, when I did my stint at Wigan, he was a young kid coming through. He was kind of the young kid looking to knock me off the peg. And you could see early signs that he was a fit kid, he was strong. And I think most of all, he was a tough kid. I've seen Mickey grow and grow. You know, he was a young, tough kid, but I think he's added that maturity to his game now. And, you know, I think it's testament to 10 years, to be a club like Wigan for 10 years and make that spot his own, really. Credit to him. And I think, you know, it'd be nice to see a great turnout for him today. And I think he'll get a good crowd on, which fully deserving.
I've had the misfortune of playing against both of you, and I don't know which one's nastiest or angriest. Who do you reckon, yourself or Mickey Mack?
I'm probably a little bit angrier than Mickey, but he might get me a little bit tougher side. So, yeah, as I said to Alex before, man, I've probably got little man syndrome, Manibo, where Mickey's just a tough cookie. So, yeah, it must be an ucker thing. I don't know what it is.
Well, let's get down the sports village as we go to Lee versus Wigan.
I am so excited. I'm here with Henderson Gill, and I tell you, there's so many fans of yours at our Rugby M office. There's a full generation of rugby league players who don't know about this guy, Henderson Gill, who was an absolute legend in the 80s when I was growing up. And what we need are guys like this, the real characters. It was like the Chris Eubank of rugby league with the little shimmies and the little dances back in the day. I was watching one of your tries, the 1985 Challenge Cup final against Hull. Brett Kenny throws a wide ball. Yeah. The ball and you skin two or three old players. What really amazed me in that play was how deep you were in your own half, almost within your own 20, and the fact they shipped it so wide and so deep. Was that a part of the way that rugby league players played back in them days? Was it just because you had people like Brett Kenny who were so skillful?
Well, what it was, to be honest, when you got players like Brett Kenny on your side, he was one of the most amazing players I've ever played alongside.
Yep.
When Wigan brought him, Wingers saw the ball. You know, he was just so naturally talented and gifted. It was unbelievable. So when he threw that ball out, I knew it was coming. I know they used to always tell me, stand deep. But I never stood deep. I was quick enough from the standing start. So I didn't have to stand as deep as what other players did. And I knew it was coming. It worked with practicing, training. He always puts a long ball out. And I just knew when I got that ball in my hand, when he gave it to David Stevenson and Stevenson gave it to me, I knew that was it. I were off down the touchline. It was unbelievable. I'll never forget it. But the main thing that I was 10 foot tall for that game, because when I walked out of Wembley and I came out the tunnel, out of 100,000 people, I saw my family down the touchline.
Wow.
All my family. So I grew in stature, and that was it. I were ready for that game.
And I've heard so many stories as well. You had a real inner self-belief about your own ability. And you've just been talking in there, doing a bit of corporate Q&A. And the fact that you looked at opposition fullbacks and thought, I'm going to beat you today. My opposition winger fullback, you're getting skinned.
Well, that was it. Fullbacks, I wanted to beat them all. Gary Kemble, he was the great Kiwi fullback. Had to do him, you know, so it was in my mind, and I always believed, you know, in myself. You know, I come from the streets, I believe in myself. You know, I had to work hard to get where I was, you know, against all the hurdles in the 80s. You know, so really, you know, doing something like that, it was a great thing for me. Plus, as well, it made my family proud.
Just lastly, Steve Hampson and Paul, we're going to get him out and have a little chat. What was he like? He's a bit of a fantastic fullback legend at Wigan, big fans' favourite.
Believe me, right, when I tell you, he's the greatest fullback I have ever seen and played alongside. You know, he was very unlucky because the first two times we went to Wembley, he broke his arm and he broke his leg, so he missed out. But honestly, he's unbelievable. I've never seen, even in the game playing today, I haven't seen any fullbacks like him.
Let's go get Steve and Paul out here and have a little chat with him. Henderson, thank you very much, sir.
It's been a pleasure, right? I've Cheers. Really enjoyed it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry. Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
Welcome back to part two here at Rugby M. We've all got one of these. It's our boarding pass for our flight to Canada, over to Toronto with Air Transat, announcing the biggest deal in rugby league history right now is the main man, Eric Perez, before we catch up with these two on Toronto teammates. We're here today at the home of Cedulo, a beautiful, this is an accountant's, this is like the most balling accountant's ever.
Yeah.
This is how you roll.
That's how we roll. Cedulo, baby, the best accountant in Manchester.
Yeah. And we're here today because you launched the new kit, which is beautiful.
Yes,
and also, you've announced the biggest deal, sponsorship in rugby league history.
Yep. Yep. It's been a big day.
3 years with
Air Transat.
Yep.
They'll be taking care of all the flights for us and for the opponents, and they'll be offering super affordable packages for the fans. So, yeah, couldn't be more excited about it.
It's probably going to start off, realistically, quite quiet as far as flights from spectators for the lower, the League One teams. But I can really see it picking up as you move into the eights and into the Super League. This could be a new destination for summer, another Catalan, another great day out.
Yep.
With the family over to Toronto, what a fantastic opportunity.
Yeah, it's pretty big. Actually, you'll be surprised. There's some of the clubs have been inundated with requests for travel packages to come over in the hundreds. So at the League One level.
No way.
Yeah, and you know, if you look at Wigan, who traveled over to Australia a couple of years ago, they brought a few thousand fans with them. We expect that by 2019, when we're in Super League, hopefully. We expect those types of numbers coming over to Toronto. It's a much easier place to get to. It's only a 6-hour flight away and much more affordable than going to Australia. So it should be good.
Rugby League in Canada is really down to you. You must be really, really proud to be sitting here and obviously starting a show 6 years ago, one-man band, earning no money. Now you're getting paid for something you love.
Yeah.
Is it still a little bit surreal or is it sunk in yet?
No, because I'm still cracking on with my goals.
Yeah.
So I don't look back at the past. I just look at the future and I just think of where I want to be. And I enjoy the journey. So actually, even when I was not making money, and I enjoyed the journey. I enjoyed it. So and I always enjoy it. So as long as you enjoy the journey, then that's what life is all about, because it could be snuffed away in a second. So you got to enjoy it while it's there. A bit dark for Rugby AM, but yeah.
It's all good. It's all good. It's deep. We're going deep today. First show back.
Yeah.
We're coming over to Toronto for the first game, May the 6th.
Yeah.
Can't wait, but please tell me the dream. What have I got to look forward to in Toronto?
So Toronto is a super cosmopolitan city. 6 million people in the Toronto area. Downtown is just absolutely popping. A home of Drake, as you know, as you love Drake, right? You love Drake, right?
Yeah, guilty pleasure. Guilty charged.
Yeah. And the food is incredible. The people are super friendly. The nightlife is popping. It's just pretty much the best sporting atmosphere in North America.
You mentioned Drake. You got some celebrity fans. Tell us a little bit about Lennox Lewis, we know, is a fan.
Yeah.
And Michael Bisping were at your launch.
Yeah, Michael Bisping. He was, I think he was in filming Triple X. And he's good friends with a good friend of mine, Jason. And he came over to support. And then I came and supported him when he fought Dan Henderson here, which was in an incredible fight. Yeah.
Mate, like you say, sport in Canada is huge. Now, the toughest thing that you boxed off today
with Air Transat is the travel side of things.
Yeah.
Looking towards, we've got to look long term, looking towards the World Cup.
Yeah.
Can Canada and America pull together an amazing spectacle of an event?
Yeah, listen, that remains to be seen. I'm not involved in that group, but we'll support them in whatever they need, and hopefully they can. But the main thing is, whether or not they do, or whether or not the World Cup actually is in North America, Toronto Wolfpack will be setting the marker down, and Toronto Wolfpack will be the ones who set the stage for rugby league in North America, no matter what.
Yeah. I've had two of you boys here today. We're going to see them in a minute on teammates, talking about teammates. Tell us a little bit about the team and how the boys have been gelling.
Look, and I was actually just at training yesterday, and it's like a family. You know what I mean? I've been around a lot of teams in my life, but this team is just, we've really gelled quickly. And the fact that we're going to be traveling a lot together will only further gel the team. I think there's a great group of guys, a lot of good personalities, a lot of big personalities. Yeah, so pretty excited about that.
Who's your favorite player?
Well, I love all of them equally. But if I had to pick an actual favorite player, I'll let you know after the first game. So our first game, we're playing London Scholars.
London Scholars, we'll be down there.
Yeah, we'll be taking the Scholars to school in the first game in London. So hopefully the fans in London come out and support their team because they're going to need it. And, you know, we look forward to, you know, more of the same, victory, commitment to excellence.
Well, I wish you every single bit of luck, mate, and I don't think you're going to need it. I think you're going to smoke the division. Mm. But right now, we've got teammates, the two of your main stars, Gary Wheeler and Andrew Dixon.
Yeah, the best-looking crew.
Hi, I'm Andrew Dixon, Toronto Wolfpack, back row, big name, Dicko.
I'm Gary Wheeler. Halfback in a props body, wheels, pig dog, bacon, bacon, I've got them all.
Jax is probably the strongest. Reece Jax, he's pretty strong on the chins as well. Does about 40-50 kilos, doesn't he?
Jaxy on the push, I reckon. Yeah. Well, he's quite good on the squats.
It's not me anyway, I know that.
Nah, it's
not definitely Jake Emmett, 100% Jake Emmett is the fattest.
Yeah, Jake's diet's pretty bad. I've seen him.
In the Lanky bus in the morning, we'll get in, he'll have his Egg McMuffin and his coffee and that. So.
Wash it down with 3 Krispy Kreme donuts. That's his usual routine. I don't think it's going to change.
Oh. I reckon you're pretty bad, aren't you?
Me?
Yeah, you're over.
No, it's got to be one of the ex-Lee lads.
Nah.
Of course.
Liam's.
Yeah,
quite,
Liam's up there, yeah.
A lot of love for Liam.
Yeah, Liam Kerr probably.
Yeah.
Jake, without a doubt. Every morning he moans on the way to training what we're going to do, and then he moans all the way back about what we've done.
Yeah,
nah,
yeah,
I
agree Johnny Powell likes to think he's fashionable, but he's a bit out there, isn't he?
Yeah, he's too out there. Blake's fashionable, but he's well out there.
Yeah, right? Yeah. He doesn't wear a top half the time, does he, Blake?
Not got many good dress senses, to be fair. But.
You like my camouflage top the other day, don't you?
Nah, dick or two. I'd probably say myself, to be honest.
Nah, not you.
Jammer.
Yeah, Jammer. James Lifeway, 100%.
He's losing his hair at the minute, so...
Yeah.
He's been secretly running clinic.
We shouldn't have really told anyone about that, should we, really?
I've got pictures, he's telling me on Instagram, he's crying every day about it. But, yeah, his image just took a dint at the minute.
Yeah, it's not the best. Bob Bezic, it's pretty bad. Yeah. If you're driving in with him, it's... It's an emotional...
It's an emotional drive.
Yeah, it's an emotional roller coaster. You're up and down all the way through.
Yeah. Paranol's quite bad. Yeah. He's good, but he's very dated.
Yeah, he likes his Oasis, doesn't he?
Yeah, but he can't knock Oasis.
I know, but...
You're pretty bad, to be honest.
I'm all right. I like a bit of grime, don't I?
Jake. probably.
You'd pick Jake.
He'd probably kill himself before I'd have to do it. So.
I suppose you could eat him, couldn't you?
Yeah,
you could eat him.
As in, Johnny Parnell would be good.
It'd be good, good,
good comedy value.
Humour, yeah.
Probably Parnell.
It could be like your Wilson, couldn't it? Like, you know, like Tom Hanks.
I'd take Johnny just for comedy.
Yeah, Johnny'd be all right. Yeah, I'd go Johnny as well. You're quite annoying.
Jammer, but yeah, I'm annoying.
Yeah, you are quite annoying.
I intentionally be annoying, but Jammer's unintentional.
He's just very slow, isn't he? Slow in everything he does.
So calling the sloth.
In the Lanky bus in the morning, he'll be the last one to the car, last one getting the coffees. So, yeah.
And he won't buy a coffee round either.
But you like to do pranks, don't you? Which is always fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jake
Emmett, yeah. He's
Bob's pretty bad though for a conditioner.
He would hate that.
Nah, Jake. Nah,
I just would. Yeah, you just let Jake do his thing, don't you?
And then, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Parnell.
Stand it. Yeah.
Parnell loves it.
He likes to think he is, isn't he?
Johnny has to make the effort to be the last man out, and then whinging about it for 3 days hangover.
Rich Whiting likes a night out, doesn't he?
Yeah, with cash in his hand. Yeah, Parnell. Define Long.
Ollie. Craig Hall.
He takes
a while, doesn't
he? Yeah, he does.
It takes a long time.
Jammers. Yeah. Craig Hall.
Craig Hall, 100%.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry. Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.
Welcome back to part three, right here, Rugby M. It's this man's special day. Mickey McLaurin, 10 years at Wigan, and you're a Leeds lad. It's like sacrilege for Jonesy. Jonesy's sat alongside you. Mickey, you must be really proud, mate, to do 10 years at such a great club.
Yeah, it's been great, mate. Jonesy's been digging me. I've been there 12 years since I was 16, but 10 years in the first team, so you know, I've spent nearly half my life there now.
Unfortunately, he can't play today. Lee versus Wigan. The football won't let you do a game. How bad's that?
Yeah, out of my hands, so I had to play it at Lee, but you know, Derek Bowman and Lee have been fantastic, so you know, I just want to say thank you to them.
Mate, you didn't recognise him, did you?
No, I just passed him upstairs, and he's, you know, I think Marwan Kukash's got his work cut out because he looks like a different person.
He's lost so much weight. We'll catch up with Derek later on in the show. Jonesy, you've mentioned on many occasions, I'll tell you a little story, true story. Big old Crabtree, I spoke to him, I says, after your time in hell, what are you not going to miss about rugby league? And he says, like, Mickey McLaurin, because he's pulling his hair, getting stuck into him.
Shouldn't have long hair, should he? Should be like this man here.
That's it.
What kind of competitor is he on field, Jonesy?
I remember the first time playing at DW against him, and I thought, young lad, small lad, he don't look that big. I want to run straight at him, and he whacked me big time. And I thought, wow, go somewhere else next time. But I'm not surprised he's a tough little character. He's from Leeds. He come through standing in the club as well. So he's one of our boys. My only grievance is he did all his career at Wigan, but it's been a fantastic career. But I wanted to ask you, Mickey, obviously Wigan won the title last year. 2015, Leeds won the treble, and unfortunately through injury, I wasn't able to play in that year when they did the big three, having played in 18 finals up to them. How did you sort of deal with missing out last year and seeing Wigan do the final?
To be honest, Jonesy, I'm not really one for go to every game. You know, I'm not really into rugby as much as, you know, some people who play the game. So, I mean, I took myself even further away from that, you know, and just took myself away from it as much, you know, so it wasn't in my face all the time. But you know, as the lads started doing well and that, I started getting a bit more involved. You know, people like Sammy Powell tried to help him out as much as I could, and the lads, you know, to see the lads win it for the first time, you know, it meant a lot to me, because I know what it feels like to win your first trophy, and you know, a lot of these lads hadn't done that. They lost the previous two, so yeah. To get that monkey off the back, you know, I was made up for them.
I won't change a thing. I think it's not about us as individuals. We give whatever we've got to the team, quite sacrificial, and you certainly do perform like nobody I've ever known. So it's great to be able to see your team do really well. And one of the things that I managed to do while I was injured was focus my mind on other things. I did a theatre play, started doing a bit of charity work. You've had a testimonial plan, which is really exciting. It's something to really celebrate. So did that take your mind off it as well, thinking about what you're going to do this year?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I've said it past, if there ever good times to break my leg last year was the time. Because like you say, I've been able to channel all my energy into my testimonial. I'll try and get everything right for this year.
And what have you got coming up? About obviously your game today, you've got a Valentine's. Yeah. What can the Wigan fans and the fans out there who are big Mickey McLaurin fans look forward to coming and supporting you in?
I'm having a big dinner at Manchester on the 11th of March at the Palace Hotel, and I'm taking it up to Whitehaven. I'm sure the Mariners will love it up there.
Love it, the Mariners, jam eaters.
Then golf day, race day, so you know, there's plenty of stuff going on next year.
And you need to sell that as well, don't you? Because he's had to front up some at risk. He's had to pay out,
He's got Manchester support.
He's a tight lead, lad, so...
You'll know about this, but from Yorkshire.
Get there and support him. So what can people do to get involved with that? Where do they need to go buy tickets?
Just check on social media, Facebook, Twitter. It's all on there, where the links are and everything to buy it. So
MMC9_17. Get involved, follow him. I've got to ask you, looking forward towards 2017, because a lot of people have tipped Wigan up again, because you won the title, this Super League last year, with a lot of young kids who have been thrown in there, no real right to, underdogs on the day. And I always remember being at the final, looking around the stadium, it was three sides full Wigan. The Wigan fans really turned that in force. And this year, you've got all the great players coming back who were missing. Are you excited for this season?
Yeah, I can't wait for it. You know, you talk about the young kids who come in last year and did a great job. That's going to stand the squad in good stead next year. I'm sorry, this year. You know, them kids that might have got much game time and that, you know, they've had a lot, they proved themselves. So, you know, players like us who are a bit more established, we're pumped to perform, to get back in the team.
And lastly, mate, for me, there's one man who I did speak to the other day, and he's really missing you a lot. It's the Sarge. He's one of the most unique people I've ever met in rugby league. Real live wire, funny, and he's got to have the worst tan in Australia. He's the palest man. What's he going to be like without the Sarge?
Yeah, it's going to be quiet for sure. But yeah, he was a great bloke around the place. Always, you know, quite loud. But he's a genuine diamond geezer. apparently, his first session, he got sunburn, had to come in. That is a true story.
That is a true story.
Factor 500. Yeah. I was thinking earlier, Mick, obviously being a standing lad, the amateur rugby in Wigan is massive. It's almost like what football is to Liverpool. Yeah. And one of the ideas I've already mentioned to you, that we maybe could get an ex-Stanningly professional group of players, you know, like Jamie Peacock, Gareth Carvel, Ryan Atkins, Ash Gibson, they could go on and on, bring them together and maybe play against the professionals that some of them might be out there, played for St. Pat's, in Shrewsbridge, St. Jude's. Do you reckon we could get that on and have a proper amateur battle?
Yeah, I think it'd be great. You know, like you say, there's like Wigan St. Pat's are probably the most renowned team in Wigan, and you know, Stanley have done quite well with the professionals. So, you know, I don't think it'd be hard to get a 13 together or 17 even. So, I think it'll go down real well.
Mate, it could be an end of the testimonial job. What do you reckon? Wrap it up,
Stanley. Mate, no all's bad. Amateur rugby, there's no hiding place. Henderson Gill reckoned he was the best fullback he's ever seen, ever played with. Steve Hampson is right here, mate. You're looking like you could go play a game today. You're like Benjamin Button. You get younger every time I see you. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. I like to go training. I'm still training now. I'm a bit sad, really. I get up at like 5, 6 in the morning, go and train, do my bit. A lot of cycling nowadays, no running. But no, I still enjoy the training side.
Mate, I was really excited that I was coming over to this game and I'm going to see you. Because I've got a Great Britain shirt from 2007. The last time we had a Great Britain tour against the Kiwis there. Well, it wasn't a Great Britain tour, it was a Great Britain test against the Kiwis. We won 3-0 and I've got your signature that I need to get. Because we won it and everybody went mad and there's a load that I need to catch up. So will you do that for me, mate, afterwards?
Absolutely, yeah. It was a great event, that, wasn't it? When we beat the Kiwis 3-0, 2007. Yep. I did the strength and conditioning side. Absolutely brilliant. Great bunch of lads. Really enjoyed myself.
And the strength and conditioning, you've done some real celebrities, haven't you? Flintoff being one. Just give us a bit of an insight into what you've been doing with some of these sporting worldly celebrities.
Well, I got a call off Neil Fairbrother, who plays for Lancashire Cricket, and just said, we've got a young kid coming up, want somebody to train him. So I sort of looked after Freddie for like 3 years. Absolutely fabulous kid, brilliant guy, works well, worked really, really hard. I was made up with him. But also I've done the likes of Lee Westwood, Darren Clark, the two golfers. I've been a Sale Rugby Union, so I've had the old, when Jason Robinson was there. So yeah, I've done a few teams in celebs.
And Freddie Flintoff fell in the river and you had to save him, did you?
Well, what happened there is him and a few of the lads, because I was coach, I couldn't go out for a beer with the lads because I stayed with Henry Morris, who was the chairman. And believe it or not, they all had a walk down the canal looking for some more bars. And Freddie decided to have a sleep on one of the benches. Lo and behold, he fell asleep, the lads left him, he got up, started to walk back to the hotel and fell in the canal. So that's typical Freddie, but that was a long time ago. I don't think you can see him doing that again.
Wow, superstar. Just give us a bit of an insight into Mickey McLaurin's testimonial. Unfortunately, he can't play today. Obviously, he's still injured. And I wanted to ask you, I can relate to how he felt missing out in the last year's Grand Final. In 2015, Leeds did the treble. Unfortunately, I wasn't fit either. It was the first set of finals I've missed in 10 years. And I wanted to ask you about your own experiences missing out in finals, three of them, I believe, in Challenge Cups with broken arms when Wigan were at their zenith and winning trophies every year. How did you deal with it back then?
Well, the first one that I actually missed was against Hull in 1985. I broke my leg, I think it was about 3 weeks before the actual final. Didn't really think much of it because I didn't really know much about Wembley. I'd only been in the game a couple of months.
Yeah.
So I didn't really know, but when I missed out the second one and the third one with broken arms, I was sort of very disappointed and I started thinking to myself, will I ever make this Challenge Cup final? And then, lo and behold, I get to play on five on the bounce.
How did you keep breaking your arm? What were you doing?
People kept ducking into my arm and I kept hitting them on the head.
And just looking back to Henderson Gill, what was he like? He's allegedly one of the biggest characters Rugby League's ever had.
Yeah, you had to keep away from him in the changing rooms because he was on his own agenda. He used to do his own things like tell jokes and all you could hear was this chuckling going on in the background and you knew it'd be Henderson. But as a player, special. You get the ball out to him as soon as possible because you know he'd do something special with it.
Right, it's getting a bit rowdy down here. All the boys are warming up, the crowd's getting nice and noisy. We're going to let Ampo get off and will you sign my top before you go?
Yeah, definitely, yeah, I'll do it now. Get me a pen.
Thank you very much.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, Spec, the specialist power contractor to industry. Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, Spec, the specialist power contractor to industry. Baby, you.
Down at Lee, we love it down here, and this man, Derek Beaumont, it was about a year ago to the day We stood outside in the freezing cold, again, Wigan friendly, and you predicted that you'd be in Super League, that you'd go unbeaten all year, and I think a lot of people have obviously listened in and thought, oh, it could be another Marwan shouting it off, but you did exactly what you said you were going to do. You took the boys away, you had a great trip, and you watched those £1 million game from the beach, just like you said you were. So firstly, before we start, give me a prediction for this year.
We'll still be in Super League at the end of it.
Top eight?
I mean, you know, you've got to weigh my, haven't
yeah.
you? You know, so the lads have got their own aspirations. For me, I don't want to put too much pressure on them, so the goal is just stay in Super League. I wouldn't want to go through what Marwan went through with a £1 million game.
Yep.
And if I'm honest with you, I wouldn't want to go through the, you know, the bottom middle eights. So privately, I think we've got a team, you know, we're spending the money, so I think, you know, we've got a team capable of being in the top eight.
Looking at your squad this year, you've got some real good recruitment going on. Glenn Stewart, I remember when Souths bought him in to replace Sam Burgess. Mm. Could you ever imagine you had a player, when the Souths signed him, that he'd be playing a couple of years later for you at Lee?
No, I mean, you don't think you're going to get players like that approaching. The difficulty is recruitment, you know.
Yeah.
When you're trying to get in, trying to get out of the Championship, the biggest, you know, objective was recruiting the right people. When you can only get in Super League with Super League players.
Yeah.
And money doesn't always talk, you know, because at the end of the day, they want to play against the best, they want to compete, they've only got a short time, they can play rugby. So talking to him, we weren't guaranteed Super League neither at that point in time. So when Travis Burns suggested, you know, Glenn Stewart, I was like, really? You know, you're winding me up, man. And the phone went on the car, ironically, Alex Murphy was ringing me over
Saturday
or other, and he's like, I said, oh, he's like, who's he? And, Travis Burns doesn't know who Alex Murphy is, that's a good one. But no, I mean, he's here, and obviously we're seeing what he's doing on the field for the first time for us, but what he's done off the field so far for this club has been absolutely fantastic.
Mate, I've heard you've got a real character from France who's not overly impressed with the accommodation in Lee so far.
Hello, he stayed in more houses in Lee than I have, and I've lived here all my life.
Anyway, about 8 houses, had he?
What a guy. He's, I tell you what, we went go-karting pre-season, you might have seen, and he is an absolute maniac.
Is
he? Yeah, he needs to go and take an English driving test if that's who he drives a go-kart. I mean, I know they didn't do the health and safety in French, and they only did it in English, but nearly killed me. I was round at his house earlier today speaking to his wife, actually, who's going to come and join
our
business and promote it in France where we do a bit of work.
Yeah.
And I was planning on not drinking, like I'm living this not drinking regime, and I thought, I'm in the car. And Eloise's father's over at the minute. He has a restaurant in Perpignan, and his uncle's over, and Kevin Leroy is in there. Who,
the Destroyer.
Was it? At OKR. And as I finished chatting up, Eloise was getting himself ready to come across here for the game, and his wife Caroline says, before you go, Eloise's dad just wants you to share a nice glass of red, some of his hospitality and a few meats. I ended up getting her about 2:15. A couple of glasses of red wine. I was like, I need a chauffeur.
What's your hopes for the game? Aside from Lee, what's your thoughts on the state of the game at the moment?
You know, we've got to keep driving it and promoting it, and, you know, keep getting the youngsters in. Our club's full of young fans, which is massively important because it gives you longevity. But I think we've got to, you know, obviously this new structure's tough.
Yeah.
OKR are going to have a good dig at getting back up. But I think if we can get some strength in that Championship where you've got 6 full-time teams that are of a standard, that are mixing it with those 4, and you have got competitiveness, and we can just grow the game.
Yeah.
Things like what you guys are doing, you know what I mean? The more media exposure we can get, the more programmes covering us, the more clubs, I think clubs have to take some individual responsibility. To try and grow and promote the game, not just in their own areas, but even outside of it. So whether that's taking an individual game somewhere, or, you know, I haven't got the answers, but I think there's a lot of quality business people in our club, on our board. There's a lot of quality owners and business people across the rest of rugby league. So if you collectively put that together as a board of any business, it costs you multi-millions to employ such people. So if we all get together for the good of the game and share our innovative ideas, I think that's got to be a way forward. And that's something I'm hoping gets done in Super League. I haven't managed to get to a meeting yet, but I do hope to. And tap into other successful men's ideas.
Mate, some great people involved with Rugby League, and I always love to meet some of the characters out on the pitch and obviously in the stand. I think you've done a great job at Lee. Best luck for the rest of the year. You're a legend. Top cheers, man. Mate. Cheers. Cheers, Derek. Cheers, thank you. It's time for UK Red Security Fan Cam outside Leeds Sports Village. It's been a resounding win for Leeds today. Who have we got with you?
Laura.
And you are a?
Wigan fan.
What happened today?
It was Leeds Cup final today, that's all I Leeds Cup final.
Mickey McLaurin, what kind of player has he been for you over the last 12
Fantastic, years? And he's going to come back bigger and better and stronger.
Obviously, were you there at Old Trafford this year?
Of course I was.
Of course you were. Of course you were. And can you see past Wigan? Who's going to be the biggest challenge to Wigan this year for Super League?
Nobody.
Confident?
Nobody, yes.
Who have we got? What's your name, mate?
Zen.
Zen?
Yeah.
Is that a real name? That's awesome. We've got Zen and Joe.
Yeah.
How you doing, pal?
All right.
What happened today? Are you happy, Lee fans?
Very happy.
Who's the main man at Lee?
Probably Mickey.
Mickey, are you?
Yeah.
He's absolutely unbelievable. Zen, how many years have you been supporting Centurions?
I was born when they won the Challenge Cup, so that's how long I've been a Leeds fan.
From the day you were born, you came out.
Yeah, I'm always been a Leeds fan, through and through.
Xander's coming on to finish off the show with us. What's your name, pal?
Jack Lloyd.
Jack Lloyd and?
Tom.
Big Tom and Jack Lloyd. Right, tell us a little bit about, give us a rundown of today's game.
We smashed Wigan. We smashed them.
Wigan fans are saying it was your cup final. What do you reckon to that?
They're just
Yeah,
they just think they're good, but we're here now to steal the show and we're going to win it.
Right, then. What do you reckon, honestly, Lee are going to finish higher than Wigan this year?
Yeah, easily. Yeah, we just showed it. We didn't have our best team out today easily because we had Mickey Iron out, we had Martin Ridyard out. If we next time we play them, we'll smash them higher than that 50 times. It'll be 100 times there probably next time.
Top 8 team this year, Lee, yes or no?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that'll do for me. Cheers, lads.
But just a little thing to Lee supporters. Would you please remember you didn't play all our good team? And remember, the next team you play, you won't get the young lads on with you. We will all be out there with stronger teams.
Come here. Just shout in behind camera.
Every year, we can lose. If you put a different team out, why not put your best team out then if you lose every year?
And this man, the number one fan in Lee, and myself, over and out right here, Lee Sports Village. We'll see you for the season right here on Rugby M. Cheers, man. Cheers, Shandy. The show, a fantastic day for Mickey McLaurin, a huge win for the Lee team, 50-10. A lot of the kids out though for Wigan, it's great to see them getting a run out.
5,700 crowd as well, great turnout for Mickey Mac, testimony to what a fantastic player he's been. And yes, the score ended up being a bit of a blowaway, but Fenley's, as you know, Seymour player purpose, I'm sure it'll have no significant effect on Wigan's pre-season training.
We'll see you next week as we head over to the Lions lunch. Absolutely outstanding day, meeting some real, proper legends of the game.
Whether it's power station, factory or stadium, covering installation or maintenance, SPEC, the specialist power contractor to industry.